All right, welcome back, you guys. You know, in our culture segments, we love highlighting people working to uplift and inspire others. And the man you're about to meet is doing that every single day. Just follow his Instagram page and you will see what I am talking about. He's an ex-NFL elite turned therapist, Jay Burnett, joining me this morning to continue our coverage on Mental Health Awareness Month. Good to see you, Jay.
Hey, how you doing, Tashara?
Look, Jay, what I love about your Instagram page is that you have a certain community that you're targeting, black and brown communities. Why was it important for you to target those communities in particular?
Well, I think it's important for us to target the black and brown community because there's very little representation in the mental health space. And also when you look at the APA, which is the American Psychological Association, about less than 2% are black members. And so when you look at that being less than 2% of black members, not only do we not have representation in that space, there's also maybe a lack of competence in understanding cultural differences and cultural challenges as it pertains to the mental health.
That is very good. Look, I want you to talk about Heal Bro Heal. That's a new initiative that you have going on. What is that initiative about, and who's the target group in that initiative?
So Heal Bro Heal is really a space where we're going to be not only just working with black and brown men, but we're also going to be working with athletes. You know, I've been part of the sports culture for many years. And also, I just want to create a space for black men to begin to heal, to begin to address some of the issues and some of the fatherhood, motherhood wounds, and just even from some of the things that we have had to deal with from passed down traumas. One of the things that I know when I was an athlete, there was very little representation in the front offices for us to have safe spaces for us to be able to talk about some of the things that we were dealing with off the field. And I think it's important for us to not only just view black men or young black boys as just being these athletic specimens, but I think it's important for us to view them as being human beings. Who are they as a man, a boy, and beyond just the physicality of them, just looking at them as a whole person.
Whew, Jay, I brought you on here to share some thoughts, but sound like you out here preaching to me here this morning. Look, what do you think is impacting that? I heard you talk about athletes, but what do you think is impacting the African-American community in general the most as it relates to the mental health space?
I think a lot of time what is impacting us is just really not having the language to put to thought that some of the things that we're dealing with. So, you know, when you look at African Americans, we make up about 13.4% of the population. And a few years ago in the Mental Health Association, about 16% of African Americans reported having a mental health issue or disorder. And oftentimes, even in schools, we are often misdiagnosed. A lot of African Americans are often diagnosed with mental health disorders, such as schizophrenia, such as bipolar, rather than being diagnosed with a mood disorder, such as depression, when we share the same symptoms as our counterparts. So one of the things is, I think while the stigmas still kind of hang over our head, is that do we have a trusted space that we want to receive the proper treatment and the proper care? And that's really been my passion and why I returned back to school to become a therapist, because I noticed that there was this huge barrier that blacks, and especially black men, were not going to therapy, because I know in the locker rooms, nobody was going to talk about their issue. Mm-hmm. And most definitely was not going to talk about it, and it got back to the front office. So I think for us, it's just having a safe space and then having individuals who are competent about the challenges that we're dealing with as African Americans. And we've had to endure a lot over the past year, not just with this pandemic, but the social issues surrounding around racism, the George Floyd death. And then you think about all of the trauma that we've had to sort of inherit a lot from our generations and from our grandparents and our parents.
Jay, I'm going to jump in here, man. I feel like I can talk to you all day, and this is obviously your area of expertise. I can't let you go, though. Real quickly, Jay, can you just tell folks where they can find you and even get more information about the work that you're doing?
Yes, absolutely. You can find me on Instagram, of course, at King Jay Barnett, all one word. And KJB Coaching is also the virtual space that we have for coaching and counseling. And then also here later this month that we're going to be releasing and beginning our Just Heal Bro virtual tour, which will be open to black and brown young males of all backgrounds and walks of life.
All right, Jay Barnett, you're going to get me in trouble with my producer. But thank you so much for joining us here this morning. Appreciate you.
Thank you.